So in the last session we have covered the subqueries, analytical functions, and before that we have covered some joins, right? So today we are going to cover what is derived table, what is temp table, what is table variable, right? So select star from emp. Okay, so this is a table, right? This is a table. And I were writing this select star all the column names from a particular table you have written here. So instead of table, if you are writing one more query here, select star from emp, what happened? So you have to give alias name for this query as you can give any, right? The same result is coming, right? So what you are doing here, so instead of writing a table name emp, so you have written like a query. So you can write down that query, you can filter the results it also, like department number equal to 30, right? So this query will give the result like, so only department number 30 has. So finally, what data you are selecting? So whatever the result is coming from this table means this is a kind of derived table. This is not existing in your database, right? So you are deriving a table based on some condition, that is department number equal to 30. So if you are writing instead of a table, a query, that we are calling a derived table. Because you are writing some query based on some your derivation instead of table name. This we are calling derived table. If you observe, it's like almost similar to subquery. Some of the people were confusing, okay, this is looks like a subquery, right? So it is not a subquery, okay? It's not a subquery, it's a derived table. The subqueries we can write down in a where condition or in a select list, but it is replacing a table, right? So you can write here emp table. So instead of writing this emp table, you have written something, a query instead of this table. So that we are calling derived table. So instead of using the database table name, you are writing some query to return a result set based on some condition. If you want to write down the condition, you can write down the condition. If you are writing just simple select star from emp, then you can build any kind of logic inside that. So from that derived result, you are write down a select statement. So that we are calling it derived table. Whatever this temp table, so we can understand easily, temp means it's a temporary purpose, right? The tables, whatever the tables you are creating, so those tables are temporary, those are not permanent tables, okay? So then what is the usage of these temporary tables? Why we are creating these temporary tables, right? So we can create these temporary tables for the purpose of, for example, until this session, okay? You are calculating something, okay? You are calculating something, and you want to keep that data. You want to keep that data into some temporary table sometime, okay? Until your operation is over, you want to keep some data in some table. For example, select star from emp inner join dept. You have to give alias name, right? As e inner join as d on e dot department number equal to d dot department number, right? So this is the result is coming from here. Or I don't want to take all these columns, I want to take emp number, employee name, salary, and department name. So these are the only columns, department name. Okay, these are the four columns I want to take. So I want to keep this result into some temporary table. So the temporary table, it looks like almost similar to a normal tables in our SQL Server. So you have EMP table, right? So the temporary tables also looks like this EMP table, and you can do any kind of operations. You can write, you can create a table, and you can insert the data, you can update the data, you can do anything, but that there is some specific time for that temporary table. After that, it will automatically drop that table. There are two kind of temporary tables. So one is a local temporary table. The second one is global temporary table. Right? So what is a local temporary table? How you can create it? So the create and everything statement is similar like a tables. The difference with the permanent table and this temporary table is create table. So you have to put hash instead of the table name. You have to put hash, right? I'm going to create EMP underscore. You can give any name, local. Okay, this is my table name, and I'm going to create the table name as column names are EMP integer, employee name, varchar 100, okay, salary integer, comma, department name, varchar. Okay, so this is the local temporary table. How you are creating this local temporary table? Same, everything same. How you are creating a permanent table in your database, right? So the difference is you have to put hash in front of the table name. You can give any name for this table name. Okay, for the meaningful purpose, I have given local. Okay, right. So if I creating this one, command completed successfully. Okay, right. So I want to see whether there is any data in the table or not. Select star from the table name is hash EMP local. Right. So there is no data. It is created with the employee number, employee name, salary, department name. You can insert the data. Insert into hash EMP local values. Right. 100. RAM, salary, housing, and department name MSBA. Control affected. You can see whether there is data or not, right? There is data. Where you can, so you are seeing this permanent tables are existing in this particular test database, right? So where you can see this temporary table, local temporary table. So all these temporary tables are created in temp database. Where is the temp database? So you have to come to system databases, come to temp database, right? Temporary tables, right? So you can see this is the temporary table as EMP underscore local temporary table, right? So how we can create a global temporary table? Nothing is different. The difference is instead of putting this single hash, you can put double hash. Okay, you can make it global. Right, I'm going to create this one. Right, this is local. If I am refreshing this one, yes, the global temporary table also created. This is the local temporary table and this is the global temporary table. The difference is for the global temporary variable, you have to put double slashes. For the local temporary table, you have to put single hash. Then what is the difference between this global and local temporary? Right. So you have created two tables, right? Right. In this session, you have created two tables, right? I'm going to take one more session. That is a new query session, right? So this is one session and this is one session. So if I'm going to write down the select star from hash emp underscore local. What happened? Invalid object. Right, I'm going to write down the select star from double hash emp underscore global. Right, so this table is giving the result, but this table is invalid object name. The local temporary table is not existing in other session, but this global temporary table is existing in other session also. Right, so the difference is if you are creating any local temporary table, that will existing only for this session only. So that user only can access that table. So other connections or other sessions, even if you are coming to the other window or other user, cannot access the local temporary variable. That particular session, this is one session, okay? So the session ID is 52. Okay, this session only can access this table. The other sessions are not accessing that table. Okay, once this session is closed, once your this session is closed, then that local temporary variable is disappear. Got it? Right. I'm going to close this session. I'm going to copy all these things to other one. Control V. Right. I'm going to close this session. So if you are accessing this one, what happened? No, nothing is there. Right. So in other sessions also you can access this global temporary variable. Got it? The difference is in which session you are creating that local temporary variable. So that session only creating, that session only you have to access. In other sessions, you can't access the local temporary variable, but the global temporary variable you can multiple connections access at a time. So that is the main difference of local and temporary table. So based on your requirement, you have to create local and temporary. If there is any other sessions also required the same table, then you have to create global temporary table. If other sessions don't require the, so you want to use only particular session, then you can use local temporary table. So you can store that data into temporarily and particular table, and after you are inserting that data into and the table, then you can close that one, right? So we are just storing some temporary information into this temporary table. Okay, right. Then whatever the table variable, so these temporary tables, everything is similar like our permanent tables. You can insert, you can delete, you can update, and everything you can do. But each operation, whatever the operations you want to do on these tables, you have to do only until that particular session only. After that session, the tables are not existing, right? So you can't do anything. Okay, right. So whatever the table variable, so this table variable also almost similar like temporary table, but this table variable is not existing on even the temporary tables, even on temp databases also. This is a variable. So already we have seen, right? So how to declare a variable. For example, I want to store a single value. I want to store a single value like employee name I want to store. So you have to declare one variable, right? Employee name varchar 100 equal to ram. You have declared one variable here, that is at the rate of employee name. The same way, if I want to store, if I want to assign a set of number of rows or number of columns, then I can declare a variable with data type table, that is called table variable. Okay, how to declare, right? Declare, and the variable name you have to return, declare at the rate of emp variable. You can give you can give any name, okay? And the data type is table data type. So initially how you are giving it, if you want to store some string value, then you can give var char. If you want to store integer value, you have given integer value, integer data type. So now I want to store some table information in this particular variable. So I have given, declare the variable name and data type is table. And you have to give the column names, employee number, integer, employee name, var char, handwrite. Okay, you can do this. Got it? So now what I am going to do here, so I want to insert some data into this table variable. How we can insert into this table variable. Right, insert into this table variable. What are the list of the columns? Employee number, comma, employee name. And what are the values you are going to insert? Select EMP number, comma, ename from EMP table, right? So if you are inserting this one, yes, 14 rows inserted, right? If you want to select this table, select star from right, so all the rows are inserted into this variable. Got it? Right. So this way you can create a table variable, okay? And the same result you can insert into the temporary table also. You can create a temporary table and you can insert whatever the information you want into that temporary table, okay? So then what is the difference between this temporary table and table variable? In what scenarios we are creating this temporary table and in what scenarios we are creating table variables? Yes. So mostly if you want to deal, if you want to work on this data like 1000 rows, it's very minimal number of rows. So you can use this table variable. If you want to work more than 1000 rows, you can use temporary tables. Why? So in the performance point of view, the table variables are very less performance because there is no statistics on this table variables. This SQL server is not creating any statistics on this table variables. What is the statistics? The statistics means, so whenever we are going to execute any query against any tables, so first it will, the SQL server, it is trying to create some execution plan and it will apply some statistics. So in which way, in which process, in which execution plan if we are applying, then it will take less time, okay? So these kind of statistics the table variable is not accepting. If you are come to this temporary table, it is allowing all these kind of statistics. It is behaving like a permanent tables in our database. Okay, how this EMP table behaves, the same way these temporary tables are behaving. Okay, so in small number of rows, for 1000 rows or 2000 rows, no need to worry about the statistics and no need to worry about the performance point of view. Okay, so more than this lakhs, millions, crores, these kind of scenarios, you have to use temporary tables. Okay. And one more thing, in the whenever we are going to create a user defined functions in SQL Server, that topic will come in the next sessions. Okay, so you can't create the temporary tables inside a user defined functions. In that situation, you have to use the table variables only. Okay, and that creation syntax also different, right? Creation syntax also different. And this temporary tables will existing in your temp database, but this table variable is not existing in your temp database and it is not taking any memory. but the temporary tables, it will take some memory on your temp database, and you can create indexes on the temporary tables, but in the table variables you can't create any indexes. Indexes will improve the performance of a query. It will identifying easily row by row, row by row. Okay, it will identify easily row by row. So these are the difference between these temporary tables and table variables. Okay, right. So one example where we are exactly using this table variables is cursors. If you are coming to the cursors, okay, so what is this cursor? So you have the information like this, right? Select star from EM. Have this information, select start from employee table. So there are the 14 rows, right? If I want to do operation, if I want to do some calculation on row by row, okay, if I want to do a calculation on row by row, how we can do this operation? So you have to create a cursors. In this situation we are using cursor, right? I'm going to declare some variables. Okay, I'm going to declare some variables like at the rate of EMP number, integer, comma, and one more variable e name, varchar. So this is the way we are declaring variables, right? Comma, salary, integer. Okay, right. So these are the some sample variables, okay, and whenever you are declaring variable you have to give at the rate and data types. So how to create a cursor? So the main agenda of this cursor is you can do row by row, row by row. The cursor will move first, it will take this row, and whatever the operation you want to do on this particular row, then you can it will done. After that it will jump to second row, after that third row. In this way it will do for all the operation, whatever the operation you have mentioned, that operation on row by row basis. Okay, it will do on row basis, right? So first we have to declare a cursor, right? First we have to declare a cursor. How to declare a cursor? Declare the cursor name you have to give. Okay, I'm going to give this cursor name is EMP cursor. Okay, and you have to write down the keyword cursor. Declare cursor name, cursor, for you have to write down for select EMP number comma e name comma salary from EMP. Okay, if you see, if I execute in this query, what it will take? So the total rows, number of rows coming from this EMP table and these columns of the data, I am going to put into this cursor. Declare cursor name, cursor, for, why you are creating this cursor? So to take all this information from this EMP table, and after that I'm going to do the operation row by row, row by row, row by row, row by row. Right, there are 14 rows, I'm going to do like that. See, this result is coming from EMP table and I'm putting in this table, right? Right. So after that, what we have to do? You have to open the cursor. Open, what is the cursor name? EMP cursor. You have declared a cursor and you have assigned all the list of whatever the data you are going to do this row by row operation, that data into this cursor, and after that you have to open the cursor because you want to fetch the row by row, row by row, right? So for that you have to open the cursor, right? So after that, what I'm going to do here, I'm going to take the first row. So what is the first row? So I'm going to take this row first to do the operation. Okay, right. How to write down? Fetch next from EMP cursor into, right? So what I'm going to do here, so whatever the in this cursor we have these three columns data, right? So first I'm going to take three first row of the data, first row EMP number, EMP name, salary, okay, and I'm going to put all this data into these three variables, okay, at the rate of EMP number and at the rate of E name and at the rate of salary. Got it? So what I did here, so I have declared the cursor. Okay, and I have opened the cursor. I'm fetching the first row. Assigned to variables. Got it? First declare one cursor, and on which data you are going to do this operation, that data you have assigned into this cursor, and I'm opening this cursor, and after that I have fetched the first row. And this employee number assigned into this variable, and this EMP E name was Smith is assigned to this variable, and the salary 800 assigned into at the rate of salary. Got it? So in this way I want to loop the data. Okay, I want to loop the data for each row. How you can do? So we have one global variable in cursor. Okay, while at the rate of fetch status equal to 0. While at the rate of fetch status equal to 0 means, so it is trying to fetch row by row until all the rows is over. If there is no row, then it will take 0. Okay, until this variable, this is a global variable, automatically it will fetch the row by row. If there is no row, then it will take 0, and then this while loop will start. While loop will end, right? Right. So here what I am going to do is, I want to multiply each row salary information with 500. I want to multiply each salary with 500, right? Select at the rate of employee number, at the rate of E name, comma, at the rate of salary into 1000. Right? So for each looping, you have to fetch row by row. First, here you are fetching only first row. After that, this while loop will fetch row by row. So the same statement you have to write down here. Fetch next from EMP cursor into these three variables you have to write down. It's better to write begin end. Right? So what it will do, it will select all employee number, employee name, and each row with at the rate of salary name with 1000. So it will take row by row, right? So and it will fetch row by row n, right? Now I am going to close the cursor. Yes, the operation is, everything is over, all the rows are loop, okay, and it finally we have to close the cursor. Name is EMP cursor, right? You have closed because you were fetching all the rows and you have done some operation on that one. So finally you have to deallocate that cursor. Deallocation means you are completely removing that cursor, because if you have this cursor name in your database, you can't create another cursor with the same name. If you are not deallocating the cursor, you can't create a cursor with the same name. Okay, now I am going to execute this entire. What happened, you know? So row by row, it is doing the operation. First it is, this is the first row it is fetching, okay, and it is multiplying with 1000. Each salary it is multiplying with 1000, it is printing the deselecting all the rows, right? If you observe, so what happened? It is looks like it is a different table. It is a different result. It is, and the second one is a different result, right? So I don't want to keep like this way. I want to put all this information into one table. I want to insert all this information into one temporary table or one table variable, right? So now you can create a table variable here. Declare at the rate of em table
actually I have one question. Why do we use cursor? What is the purpose of cursor?
Yes, the purpose of cursor is, so you can, if you want to do any operation on row by row, for example, if you have 100 rows in a table, okay, 100 rows in a table,
okay. Do we use it in real time?
Yes, we are using. If performance point of view, it's not good, but in some situations we have to use this cursor, definitely.
There will be like lags in rows of rows, right? So
yes, in that situation definitely it is a performance point of view we can face the issue, okay? So I think in that situation mostly for update statement we can, okay, we can do whenever we have lags of rows of the records, we have to use for update statement like that. But select statement, for example, if you have one report, okay, for that report you want to show some data, okay, if you are using these cursors, definitely it will take some time consuming process. So that's why most of the time we are avoiding these cursors, okay? So 90% of the time we are avoiding cursors. Definitely you have to learn this cursor, okay? So why it is taking time consuming? Because it is trying to fetch row by row, row by row, row by row. It has to do the operation, this entire statement it has to run for each row, okay? Right, now what I'm going to do here, so I'm declaring one table variable, employee name, comma salary integers, right. So you have declared one table variable. So whenever you are executing this query, it is giving this data like this, right? One different result sets. I want to put all this data into one table variable. How you can put? So instead of this select statement, I'm going to put into insert into table variable, insert into at the rate of em. If you want to write down the list of the column also, you can write down, right. What happened if you are executing this entire one? Incorrect syntax near the keyword declare. What happened here? So I forget to close this, right? One row affected, right? So what happened, you know, here all the rows are inserted into this temporary table. So we can check whether the data is inserted into that temporary table or not, right? How we can check? We can select star from that table variable, right? Now I'm going to execute the entire statement, right? The entire data is inserted into this table variable. Got it? The table variable is this one. This is the usage of this table variables. So if you are coming to here, if you are not creating any table variable, and if you are not inserting row by row into this table variable, it is displaying like a different result sets, row by row. So how you can integrate all this information into one data set or into one table? So you can put into this temporary variable, right? So you can create a temporary table also here in place of this table variable, and you can insert that data into this temporary table, and after that whatever the data is coming to this table variable, you can insert into the your permanent table.
Declare, yeah. Do we use only for temporary tables?
No, temporary table creation structure is different. This is a table variable, okay? So the difference.
No, I'm asking about the declare.
Yeah, declare.
When do we use declare? Like only for temporary tables? Before we didn't
only
come
for
across
variables. Only for variables. The declare statement we are using only for variables. Whenever you are declaring a variable, you have to use declare statement. If you want to create the temporary tables, you have to use just normal like normal tables only. Okay. The difference is you have to put hash. Create table hash, the table name, and the similar, everything similar. But the variables, you have to put like a declare the variable name and what is the data type. If it is a varchar, it will store only single value. If it is an integer, it will store only one numeric value. If it is a table data type, it will maintain any number of columns. Whatever the columns you are declaring here, that much of table data it will store. So this is the syntax for declaring a table variable. So all these are temporary purpose only. But this table variable, in what situation we are using? If you want to keep a small number of rows, if you want to keep a small number of rows, you can use this table variable. If you want to maintain more lakhs, crores, millions of the data, you can use temporary table. Okay, because this is a kind of middleware platforms, right? Middleware platforms in the sense. So whatever the, for example, you have a full logic query, okay, that query gives some result. Okay, whenever you are executing some result, one query, complicated query, it will give some result. It will give some result. So before you are going to insert whatever the result is coming from the query into a permanent table, the permanent table in the sense, in databases you have some permanent tables, right? That is EMP table. So instead of, before you are going to insert that data into this EMP table, so you can store that data into temporary table, and if you want to do any operation, you can do that on that particular temporary table. Okay, after that manipulations is over, then you can directly insert into this EMP table, permanent table. Okay, because these temporary tables are not existing, these are just for like containers, just sometime until your calculations is over, until this sessions is over, that tables will exist. After this session is over, this table variable and this temporary tables all are drop. Those are not existing. Okay. So in this way, you can create a cursor. Okay. You can create a cursor and you can insert whatever the data is coming from that cursor into this table variable, or you can create a temporary table also instead of this one. Got it? Any confusion here? Close cursor and drop the cursor. Something little bit confusing, this cursor. Definitely it will confusing. So once you are practicing, then it's very very easy. Okay, what we are doing here, we are declaring one cursor and we are assigning whatever the result on which data you are going to do this operation. What operation? The simple operation I am doing here, I want to multiply 1000 with all the rows with the salaries, and I want to keep that result into some temporary table. For that, I have already created declared three variables. Okay, and so you have to open that cursor and the first row, right? The first row I'm going to fetch into these three variables. Okay, and while at the rate of fetch status equal to 0, the fetch status means it is a global variable, it will keep row by row status. Means for example, if there is any row, then it will, yes, it has a value. If there is no row, then it will make 0. right? The condition will satisfy, then it will jump to close the cursor. Until it is coming to zero, it is looping this, and whatever the operation you have put here, then that statement will execute for row by row, row by row, row by row, and finally you have to close this cursor and deallocate the cursor. Okay guys, so do you have any doubts until this one? So we'll discuss something more tomorrow session. Okay, so I'm going to close this session little bit early.